The Simpsons Hit and Run. The best way to explain it is Grand Theft Auto on Diazepam. I completely forgot how fun this game actually is. And this game is worth the price alone just for the opportunity to kick Marge Simpson right in the fanny. I don't care how much money needs to change hands, the opportunity to boot Marge Simpson in the will always be worth it, okay? Let's just make this deal happen. Who do I need to pay to kick Marge Simpson in the fanny? Remember kids, domestic violence is never funny. Unless it's Homer Simpson kicking Marge right in the fanny. That is funny. As a society, we can all agree that that is funny as f, okay? A left-wing lunatic with a short pink fringe will agree Marge getting kicked in the is a bit funny. Okay, let me take it back. The year is 2003. The Black Eyed Peas have a hit song with Where's the Love? You're in the cinema with a wee cheeky half bottle watching Return of the King. You've brought along your first date. You're trying to find out the best possible way to finger her and also eat a medium popcorn. It's a good year. What else happened in 2003? Oh yeah, kids, remember the Iraq War? But unlike the Iraq War, people still care about The Simpsons Hit and Run.
Yay!
Here, take a look.
16 years to the day, and I still hate those goddamn robotic wasps.
I haven't taken that much damage since I slept with a Nigerian prostitute in Magaluf.
He fucks that wasp up good. Boom! Krusty is flogging that merch. Homer, being the obese, greedy capitalist pig that he is, must buy one. Much like a real marriage, you can't even get out of your fucking driveway until your woman is barking orders at you to go get some ice cream.
Here, what's the cheat code to get a divorce?
Elmer Quimby, absolute certified dirtbird. Says he's a scientist, but to be honest, he looks more like a child sex trafficker or a member of the Proclaimers.
Or Frankie Boyle if he has HIV.
Here we see the moment Bart Simpson tried to apply for an Ulster Scots grant.
Bart, how old are you?
Okay, so let me just fill you in on the story here. Marge is only now going to look for Bart Simpson 24 hours after he has been declared missing, presumed dead. So once again, you just completely give up looking for your child and go speak to a man who looks like he openly fucks his sister. Also, can I draw attention to the fact that Mole Man is waiting to meet someone in a graveyard at midnight? So, you date rape your father-in-law, then the clearly mentally ill man who needs help tells you he's seen a crop circle that looks like a tin of Buzz Cola. So Marge investigates. This is a worse excuse than the fucking McCanns gave the Portuguese police for losing their child in 2003. See folks, it's all connected. Although, for a serious moment, let me be genuinely clear. I have zero involvement in the disappearance of Madeleine McCann. Again, let me state that emphatically, folks. Boom! Level 5. And it's only gonna get weirder. Look, this is how you can tell The Simpsons didn't make Apu a stereotype. Because if they did, he would be driving on the pavement screaming Allahu Akbar. Okay, brace yourself, because this script is about to go up another 3 gears. So, Apu wants the cola truck. The cola is actually a mind-controlling drug. The cola is produced by a fucking meteor. The cola can also reanimate literal fucking T-Rex bones. Use both, shit yourselves, and hide in a huge vent.
Seriously, look at the size of that vent.
Then you overhear those two aliens having a yarn about how all of humanity is on a fucking reality TV show against their will, which is being recorded by huge wasps from the start. I genuinely feel like I'm getting PTSD from playing this. So it's up to El Barto, who sounds like a drug cartel member, to stop this evil menace. And Apu will help. Jokes, Apu fucking laps it and splits off home. And that, folks, is the story of how Bart Simpson became a member of the alt-right. So you meet up with Principal Skinner after school hours without your parents, may I add? So you make your way through the literal apocalypse to try and fight the alien mothership. You throw a few cars with actual nuclear waste on them Good luck with the future cancer, Simpsons. I hope you have good, good, good hospital insurance.
I think all kids who play the Simpsons Hit and Run need to see some sort of psychiatric help.
Bingo bango, back to getting blocked on the sofa, ignoring your wife and your kids. The American dream. Simpsons Hit and Run went from Jurassic Park to Close Encounters of the fucking Truman Show in one cutscene. You know, I think as a society, we will never recover from the Simpsons Hit and Run.
And in many ways, I don't really want to.
Apart from the main story, there are a number of collectibles. I never found much appealing it myself, but if you do have Asperger's syndrome, knock yourself out. They even added in a multiplayer racetrack. I didn't even know this until years later.
And by then, I had no one to play with.
The cars and clothes are fun to unlock, so that does add a lot of motivation to get more coins.
The only bad thing I'll say about this game is that the screens are way too realistic. Like, everything around you is super cartoonish, everything looks like an episode of The Simpsons as much as it could on the PlayStation 2, but Jesus Christ, do these sound like some sort of Mexican drug cartel torture screams. Take a listen.
Who's she supposed to be?
Old Mrs. Periwinkle.
Crazy cat lady.
When it comes to gameplay, I have no idea how any child anywhere in the history of Earth ever completed this game on their own. This game, you need the help of your older brother, your dad, a fucking shaman to conjure a spirit to give you good luck, and a NASA engineer to try and take some of these jumps. Simpsons Hit and Run is impossible for a child to play. Any kid in your school who said that they completed the Simpsons Hit and Run is talking pure and utter shite. The Simpsons Hit and Run has more glitches in it than the fucking Matrix.
Playing PlayStation, ay, with your bitch, that's a fact. Playing PlayStation, ay, with your bitch, that's a fact. Playing PlayStation, ay, with your bitch, that's a fact. Playing PlayStation, ay, with your bitch, that's a fact.
The Simpsons Hit and Run is one of those rare games that's unashamedly fun. It doesn't give a fuck about realism or reality. And see, to be honest, that's probably a good thing. If this game was realistic, Marge would have had those kids taken off her like that. Bart Simpson would be up in Hyde Bank Young Offenders Center for constant vandalism. And Homer, well, he's only yellow because of years and years of serious alcohol abuse. The PlayStation 2 had almost 2,000 games released for it. 2,000, and this was up to 18 years ago. And The Simpsons Hit and Run is still being played, still being talked about. Some people can complain about certain gameplay aspects, certain lip-syncing issues, but see, to be honest, who really gives a f***? It's nearly 17, 18 years old now, and people are still playing it, still talking about it. You've still got losers making game reviews about it. You've even got people still modding this game, a PlayStation 2 game. That is just testament to genuinely how unbelievably, unashamedly fun The Simpsons Hit and Run is. Well, hopefully now you can agree that The Simpsons Hit and Run was just simply Grand Theft Auto on Diazepam. If you have any more suggestions for games you'd like me to play and review, please leave them in the comments below. Thanks a million.